I've only, we're gonna give it a couple of minutes just to see who's gonna join us. I have been so excited about this day. See what happens. Give everybody a second to get on board with us. I'm gonna clean up my mess because I was just creating while I was waiting for you all. All right, Ray, I thought you were gonna be in the car. You said you were running errands. That means you can't come while I'm online, you see. All right, just giving it a minute. All right, when you get on, I see we got some joiners. So when you get on, let me know that you're here so I know who I'm talking to. Yay! All right, well, I'm gonna post the live video anyway so that anyone that wants to can watch the replay. I know it's really hard because usually at this time of day, I'm working also. I know, Ray, it's hard to motivate when you have the day off, right? I still get out of bed at the same time because otherwise I would not get anything done and then I'd be frustrated. So I still get up, you know, at my normal 5 o'clock. Actually, this morning I slept in. I slept till 5:15. Don't tell anybody. Anyway, so I guess we're going to get started because, like I said, we're going to post the replay so that everybody can see. So I just returned back from Atlantic City a couple of days ago, and while in Atlantic City, the company unveiled the brand new 2019-2020 catalog. So, but before I show you that, now everybody that knows me knows how much I love my stamps and all my stamping accessories, and there's only one thing that I love about as much as my stamps, and I'm not talking about human beings, I'm talking about material things. So I have to show you what I got at Atlantic City. Ding, 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 ding. Can you all see that bling? Not only is it bling on the tongs pieces, but look at the sides and the back. I feel like a movie star. So I'm going to put these on because I'm on a cold tile floor. And besides, I have to be stamping in my flops. So I see we got more people that have joined us. Make sure that you let me know that you're here. I'm going to be doing some giveaway stuff too. So, all right, let's get started. I want to first show you the catalog. All right. So I can't show you the inside, but I can show you the cover. Any of you that joined my live while I was in Atlantic City, I tried to give you a preview of this so that you could get an idea. This was two of the product suites they showed us. So I should have some of those goodies in my box. Hi, Rachel. So I'm going to show you some of the items that I actually got while I was in Atlantic City. So I'm gonna turn the camera down to the table for a second because there's a pile of loot on this table that came from the event. Not those blends, those are gonna be part of my giveaways today. But these items here and these items here. So while I was waiting to go live with you all, I did a little bit of creating too, so. All right, sorry to make you seasick. Okay, so as my prize patrol, I got this background stamp called Birch, and I was really, you know, undecided about it, but this morning I got to play a little bit, so I'm going to show you what I created with that and another set. This is called Daisy Lane, and I am going to be showcasing this in all of my stamping events in June, so I am busy creating now to get ready for that. So this coordinates with the Daisy Punch, the large Daisy Punch that we already have, and coming out in the new catalog will be a medium Daisy Punch that will be able to punch this one out right here. So very simple, but with those two stamp sets, I created this just a couple of minutes ago. So you can see what the Birch set looks like stamped on paper. And I wanted to keep it not really monochromatic, but just having a couple of colors. So I added some Granny Apple Green and some Daffodil to it to kind of brighten it up a little bit. The last item in terms of stamps that I got while I was in Atlantic City is called It Starts With Art. So all of us that love stamping so much, this also has a set of coordinating framelits, which should be in my box from the UPS man. I love how they took the spools of ribbon and they turned it into a heart. And we have our blends, our standard markers, and colored pencils depicted here. So that's a real cool one. A brand new punch that's coming out. So we got that. And then I also received some patterned paper. I haven't even opened it yet. So I'm going to take it out of the package because I want you all to be able to see it. I'm hoping I'll be able to capture some of it. This is a specialty paper. And from what I understand, it has, ooh, yeah. Okay, this is mosaic. What is this called? Mosaic wood specialty paper. Hi, Jill Smith. Thanks for joining. So this has, can you see the shiny on the camera? Can somebody let me know if they can see that? But these are hummingbirds that are mosaic in style. So on the front side of the paper, there's that hummingbird. And then on the other side, there is a mosaic. So the colors in here are Blushing Bride, Crushed Curry, Garden Green, Mint Macaron, Soft Suede, Terracotta Tile, new color, and Very Vanilla and Whisper White. So thank you, Rachel, for letting me know you could see the shiny. Here's another piece. I am dying to play with this because I'm thinking if I cut it in strips, it'll make nice little strips for scrapbook pages. So this is a really pretty one. And on the back side of that, there is some Crushed Curry floral, but again, it also has that little bit of mosaic. Let me jump to the other one. I know I'm going to have a lot to show you. Here's some more of the acetate, and these are little stars or flowers. I'm not quite sure. Yeah, Jill, it is really pretty. You have to see it in person. Here's another mosaic print. It kind of reminds me of those things at the eye doctors, you know, like, look at this picture and tell me what number you see. So it kind of messes with your eyes a little bit. Okay, let's see what else we got. Ooh, okay. So this is some leaves, and all of these leaves have that shiny acetate finish. It's almost like they're embossed. I know, you guys. I agree with you. It is very, very pretty. So other side. Ooh, this is a really pretty one. This looks like a distinctive stamp, but it's got a really pretty mosaic flower, leaf, and butterfly. And let's see what else. We're almost there. Ooh, that nice mosaic. Here's one in the acetate. Ooh, that is really nice. I like that one a lot. And the back side of that is kind of boring, but that's okay because, you know, that gives us more. We know what side we want to use that way. And then one last one, and this is a mosaic pattern also with the acetate. So, okay, are you guys ready to unpack the box? I am. The UPS man came at about 7:30 last night, so I have been dying to open the box. So I'm just going to, oh, I just found an embellishment that I think would look great on that card. So these are in the new catalog. These are called Perennial Essence Floral Center. So it's part of the Perennial Essence suite. Hi, Cindy Kula. I haven't seen you in a long time. Thanks for joining. All right, so these are like little fuzzy flower centers. So that card that I created this morning that I just showed you, I think, tell me what you think, but I think these fuzzy floral centers would be like amazing right in there. Don't you? Oh, makes that daisy look so much real, so much more real. So I'm going to be doing that. I'm going to add those to my card. All right, let's get this dang box. Let's get the suspense over with. Let me grab it. Hang on. Actually, maybe I'll turn the camera this way. All right. Can you guys see the box? Here we go. Okay. I got some samples too, so we'll show you those. All right, here we go. The box weighs 16 pounds. So in case you're wondering how much stuff is in there, I'm like, you know, you only live once. So let's just do it. All right, right on the top, a brand new stamp set called A Good Man, okay? This is great for watercoloring, but it is very masculine-oriented. Hi, Candy! So the sayings, you do a great job of being a great guy. Relax your way. Thanks to you. You're the best. It's your day. I grew up loved. being a good dad starts with being a good man and for you. So this is a masculine set. I really like this guy sitting in the lounge chair. I can foresee doing some stuff for my husband with that one. So, all right, that's the first item from the box. Let's see what else we got. We got a lot of packing material. The packing slip is long. Here we go. All right, what is this? Okay. This is from the Bird Ballad Suite. I've been dying to see these in person. I've actually only seen them in the catalog, and they were really pretty. So this is called the Bird Ballad Laser Cut Cards and Tin. All right, so I don't know if you can see it, but the tin has a gold finish, nice pretty leaves. And let's look at the inside. Oh, it's all packaged up, but we're going to open it, okay, because I want you to see it. You know, you have to, if you're not here in person, I got to give you an idea. Ooh, those are nice. Okay, so vanilla envelopes. The envelopes have a scalloped edge. Very pretty. And then the cards are all laser cut. I know, Ray, isn't the tin amazing? So here is the card. The card is a laser printed card, a laser cutout card. So you can back it with any of the designer paper. I bet some of that paper that we just looked at would be amazing. So there are, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12 cards. 12 cards that come in the tin. Yeah, they're beautiful. And they're delicate, but love them. Okay, so that's the Bird Ballad tin and laser cards. Probably a card, maybe a class with that. Let me know what you all think. All right, so let's get that put away. I think I got two of those. Yep, two of those. All right, let's get that out. All right, new colors. Let's talk about the new colors. 5 new colors. All right, haven't even played with them yet. So, Rachel, I'm thinking of you. Enola, I'm thinking of you. My pal Don Griffith. This is called Purple Posy. It is a very, very pale purple. Not sure how well you can see it on there. Hopefully fairly well, but that's called Purple Posy. The next one, I'm not going to show you that one next. Let's go with this one. Pretty Peacock. This almost reminds me, when I look at it, almost of like our Island Indigo with maybe a little bit more green in it. I'm not sure. So that's that. Terracotta Tile. I've been dying to play with this one because I created, hopefully you guys saw my blog post today, I created some samplers for the gals that went with me to on stage, and I was hoping that I had a marker in that color so that I could color the flower pot, but okay, so that's Terracotta Tile. Then we have Rococo Rose, very light rose color, and the last one is Seaside Spray, okay? So these are the 5 in colors. They will be around there for 2019 to 2021. All right, let's see what else we got here. Okay. This is part of the Bird Ballad suite, but you know, you don't need to have any of the Bird Ballad stuff. It's a set of dies, and it's called Nested. Everything is packaged like so firmly. Okay, it's called Stitched Nested Label Dies. Okay, so what the heck? It's like Fort Knox. I can't even get in. All right, here we go. Let's show you these. Ooh, okay. So these are dies, and they have stitching all around. Hi, Dawn! I just mentioned your name because I was showing them the Purple Posy, and I know purple is one of your favorites. So here's the nested dies. I really like this straight edge. So today I'm going to be playing. No work getting done today. All right, what do I got here? I told you about the arts stamp set that I got. It starts with art. These are the coordinating framelits, so I'll be able to cut out the little ink bottle and the spools of ribbon and all that kind of stuff. Okay, so one of our $1 million achievers, of course I gotta find the stamp set that goes with it, because I wanna show it to you. Okay, one of our $1 million achievers, Mary Ellen Beiler, this is her stamp set. It's called to a wild rose. And this is one of the distinctive stamps. So those of you that stamped with me over Celebration know how much I love the painted seasons, because when you stamp with it, it looks absolutely real. It's like a photograph. So this is another distinctive stamp set, and it has coordinating framelits. So all these pretty images, as well as some additional ones. You all want to see them? Do you want to see what the additional pieces are? All right. Thank God for teeth. All right, let's see. These new packages, these new die packages are tricky to open, but I think our pieces won't fall out, so that'll be really nice. All right, so, ooh, look at those. All right, look at these. Look at the intricacy here. This little piece here, I make a nice belly band or a nice edging on the card. We have a delicate flower, very detailed, and then, of course, the outline image. And then there is also one stitched label inside of this. And this coordinates with the To a Wild Rose, okay? So let's put that aside. I have a feeling this table's gonna get crowded. Okay. All right, so those of you that were oohing and aahing over the cover of the catalog, this stamp set has an entire product suite, and it is called Come Sail Away. It is a more masculine, or I should say nautical, because anybody that loves the ocean don't have to be a guy or a gal. I love the ocean, and I just love the set. So this has the stamp set and coordinating framelits. I'm trying to get them out as quickly as possible, you guys. Whew. Okay, here's the stamp set. Sailing Home, it's called. Beautiful lighthouse, lots of detail. Hopefully you guys can see that. Sailboat, anchor, compass, rope knots, a smaller sailboat. The sayings say, you are my true north. Let hope be your anchor through the storms of life. Congrats. Set sail in the direction of your dreams, and thanks. And then we have the coordinating framelits that go with it. So the framelit that cuts out the large and small sailboat, a different type of knot. We got a little bit of sea life here, like greenery, a captain's wheel. What else? Another label and another label. So really, really nice diversified set. Let me see if I can dig deep in the box and I can find the coordinating designer paper. Here it is. So let me show you that coordinating paper. I bought a couple of these because I just foresee. Hi, Annette. All right, let's see. I don't know if Jane was going to get up early. Jane is out in Arizona, and she was going to join us. Last time she joined me live, I couldn't see any of her comments. So, Jane, just in case, I'm not sure. All right, so we have the compass, and it's a Knight of Navy, balmy blue, basic black, mossy meadow, soft suede, and whisper white. So we have the compass, and then on the back side of the compass, some green directional like maps. I like this one too. It's kind of like a newsprint, but it's all about the sea, ocean, and all that kind of stuff. And then on the back side, I might as well just take these right out of here because I'm gonna anyway. Then you'll be able to see them better. After I get done with these live videos, it's so funny because this room is a complete disaster, more so than usual. All right, so on the back of the newsprint, we have the Knight of Navy and soft suede knots. All right. This reminds me of a masculine wallpaper. Don't know if you can actually see it really good there or not, but Knight of Navy, balmy blue, vanilla maybe. Backside looks like it could be some coral. Or a leafy kind of pattern. Little sailboats, again, kind of reminds me of a wallpaper. Backside, green stripes, this way or this way, your choice. Let's see. Lighter stripes in the balmy blue, closer together. And the backside of that one, compass. Compass, compass, yes, a couple different ones. And then we have little lighthouses and then some really nice stripes. This kind of looks like a denim in case. Yeah. So how does everybody feel about this masculine collection or the nautical collection? I know I keep saying masculine. Same package, just a second one. There is also a set of Memories and More cards. I'm going to pull those out that go with this whole suite, this Come Sail Away suite. I'm going to break a nail. Then I'm going to, hey, check out these nails. Look at these. I feel like a movie star, like I got diamonds all over my hands. All right. All right. Kathy joined us. Okay, so for the first person's comment that I see that tells me the name of the prize patrol that I won, will get... I got some Stampin' Blends. You'll get your choice of which color you want. I got some Smoky Slate, some Crumb Cake, some, I think, a Daffodil, and some Old Olive. So, the first person that can tell me what the name of my prize patrol was, then we'll get one of those blends. Thanks for tuning in. Okay, so this is the Memory and More cards that go with that same collection, but what I really want to show you is some of the phenomenal pieces that are in here. Oh, good guess, Ray. That wasn't it. Ray says the medium daisy, but it's not the medium daisy. Good guess. Keep going. Keep going. All right. Look at this laser cut piece that's part of the Memory and More collection that goes with this same suite. So you have all these Memory and More cards that you can create. Anchors away. There's more laser cut pieces. Oh, here's another one. So I just don't want to bend them. Okay. Look at this. These split in half to make two cards with. So you have a sailboat with the sunset. Dan Bolte, you guessed birch. You got the right answer. We got Dan and Rachel on, both of you. I guess that's a happy household. So let me know what color blend you're looking for. I have olive light and dark, crumb cake light and dark. I have daffodil, so you get to pick which color you want. I'll mark it with your name on it. Dan Bolte, can you believe that? I love it. That's great. All right, some self-adhesive die cuts that are also in this collection. Oh, here's another laser cut piece. Look at this. Beautiful. Okay, so laser die cut pieces. These are all stickers, but I like to call them self-adhesive die cuts because it sounds better. Here's some more, and you get two sheets of each of these. So that's the Memory and More card pack. These are a huge seller. So not only do we get them in the 4x6 size, but you also get them in the 2x3 size. So, and you got two different packs of those. Oh, it's Rachel. She's using Dan's iPad. Okay, so Rachel, you make sure you let me know what color blend you want because you're my first giveaway. All right. So keep paying attention because you don't know what I'm going to ask. All right, so the next thing, let's see what else is in here. Magnolia. Okay, this was a big product suite. Everybody loved this. This is called Good Morning Magnolia. This is the stamp set. So we have a nice large magnolia flower with the word hello and the word thanks. And then we also have the second, it's a two stamp set case. Not only for what you do, but for being someone so special. Enjoy today. The journey of life is best shared with a friend. We'll get through it together. Thinking of you. I really like this little piece right here. And then a closed up magnolia bud. So, yeah. Yep. And then this also has a set of coordinating framelits that cut out all the pieces. So, those all go together. All right. Let's see what else is in this box. Does anybody want to see? Did I not order that? I had to have ordered that. No, I'm hoping. Okay. So this is the Magnolia Lane designer paper. This is delicious. Okay, so let's see it. Let's see it. I know you guys seem to really like the designer paper. I apologize, so block your ears if you don't like, you know, foul language, but I know there's a lot of paper whores out there. I used to be one of them. Chop it up. Chop it. Use it. remember, Stampin' Up! Is always coming out with new designs, so don't be afraid, because there'll be something beautiful coming before you know it. So this has, it looks, it's black, basic black. I'm trying to do it from memory. Let's see on the back of the package. It'll tell me. Basic black, early espresso, mossy meadow, petal pink, so saffron, and whisper white. So we got some magnolias on this side, some pink stripes on that side. The next sheet, well, let's just take it out of the package, do what I do best, make a mess. All right, so, we and there's the stripes. Petal pink. All right, this one's got the petal pink and the mossy meadow. Hopefully I'm not making anybody sick. Good job, Kathy. See, you can make cards much faster. All right, that, oh, here's another different magnolia print, but the same color scheme. It is so beautiful. This, to me, would make an absolutely fabulous background for a card, and then a nice big greeting right on the front, a nice chunky greeting. All right, so some leaves, backside. Those petals are just painted so pretty. Petal pink, ha ha ha, no pun intended. I know, I got lots of thumbs up and hearts on that one. I know, it's pretty, isn't it? All right, some green stripes. On the other side of the green stripes, more magnolias, just a different opening, different size, different position, right on the branches. Those are really pretty too. This one I really like. The green and the petal pink stripe. Again, scrapbookers, nice borders, cut nice symmetrical borders. It is gorgeous, Rachel. I agree with you. This is a nice, pretty, subtle one. It's got the petal pink background and the baby magnolias on it, little baby ones. Same leaf pattern, but with the espresso background. I think we got to all of them. Yeah, which one's your favorite? Which one is your favorite? I don't know. I like these with the black background the best. They're my favorite. They're my favorite. They're just so good. All right. Now, I can't even tell you which one's going to be my favorite DSP, because there's another DSP. Are you sick of DSP yet? Because I'm not. My in-color papers. I already showed you the ink pads, but in case you tuned in late, I'm going to show you the five colors again. This time I've got them in paper. So we have Purple Posy, a light, light, light purple. We have Terracotta Tile, kind of like a terracotta flower pot. Seaside Spray, which is like a, I don't know, it's a bluey purple, but I don't know. We don't have anything like it, so it's something totally different. Pretty Peacock, the paper does make it show you, it's not like the, it is not Island Indigo, and it is not, not quite navy. It does have a little bit more green in it. And then the Rococo Rose. All right, so that's that. What else do I have? Oh, my stuff is falling all over. All right, I'm almost seeing the bottom of the box. Okay, there's another product suite in here. And that product suite includes, it's called the Floral Essence product suite. Oh no, this got broken in the box. Ah, darn. Okay, so can I rewind for 1 second? The first paper that I showed you, the mosaic, look at these. These are embellishments. Oh my God, they're so pretty. These go with the mosaic collection, and I just had to have them because they, you know me, I like bling, and they looked really gemmy to me. So the colors in here, I believe, are saffron, maybe. I'm not sure. I think it's saffron pool party and maybe the Rococo Rose. I'm not quite sure. Or maybe it's daffodil. I don't know. But they're really pretty. Okay. So the next product suite is called Perennial or Floral Essence, I believe. So the Floral Essence product suite includes a stamp set. Do you guys want to see a sample with this? Let me just show you because it doesn't do it any justice. Okay. So here is a sample created with this stamp set. So I know. It's so pretty. I know. So, floral essence, and then this has a punch. Almost looks like an airplane propeller. We teased about that the whole time we were gone. And then if you look at it, I see a man's tie. These are the pieces that go under his neck, and that's the piece that hangs down. You know, he's a chubby guy, but what can I say? It's all right. So that cuts out this petal here, and that's what I used. Hi, Jen! Hi, Jen! Don't get in trouble being online. So that propeller punch made these petals for the flower. So I know. Well, good, Ray. I'm glad you like it. So that's that particular one. And so in addition to those two items in the suite, there is also 12 by 12 vellum paper. The vellum paper comes 6 sheets, I believe. No, 12 sheets. So it is 4 sheets of 3 colors. I believe it is petal pink, old olive, and I'm not sure what the 3rd color is. I can't remember. Oh, saffron, I think. Okay. So yes, 12 sheets of vellum. So we have the petal pink vellum. That's what I made those flowers from on that sample card. Old olive vellum and... Yes, Virginia. Virginia just said that the big bunny ears for this punch. I agree. Good thinking outside that box. And then these are the saffron vellum sheets. So there's 12 sheets of vellum, 12 by 12 vellum in this pack. Okay. So again, that goes with the floral essence. One more piece of the floral essence. I think this is part of floral essence. I gotta check now because I don't want to tell you the wrong thing. And regardless, I can't open this book in front of you because that would be against the rules. But does this not look like a beautiful oil painting? Oh my God. Let's open this beauty and let's see. Because I know that all my girls out there that are watching, they all love designer paper as much as I do. So, the colors in this pack are Balmy Blue, Blackberry Bliss, Blueberry Bushel, Calypso Coral, Crushed Curry, Flirty Flamingo, Mossy Meadow, Old Olive, Petal Pink, So Saffron, and Whisper White. Holy cow, it's going to match with everything. Okay, so this piece that looks like the oil painting has a backside that is, I know my lights are so bright in here, I'm not sure if you can actually see that. Let me step this way a little bit. So it's kind of swirly. Yeah, Rachel, I'm telling you. I can just imagine some of your explosion cards made with that. Oh, my husband's supposed to be working and he's watching. All right, another oil painting background. I like this one a lot because it has the pink in it. You know me, I'm a pink girl. And on the back side, some really pretty green that just looks like a canvas that's just waiting for something else to get added to it. Whoops. All right, moving on. Let's see. Here's another painted background. Don't worry, Paul, I'll still have time to make dinner. This one here would match nicely with the daisy set. The backside of this one, oh, look at that. Holy cow. Reminds me of, if I could see the northern lights, is that what they would look like? Does anybody know? All right, continuing, look at this. Another painting. This would look beautiful just in a frame hanging on the wall with, you know, like a little logo or something. I don't know. Hey, Paul, Donnie's saying hi to you. Here's another beautiful background. Can't wait to see what everybody creates with this stuff. All right. Oh, Dawn, Rachel, who else? All my purple fanatics out there. Look at this one. Are these poppies? What are they? I don't know, but they are beautiful. Okay, other side. This way? I'm not sure which way, but it's a smaller version of one of the other ones that we showed. And then the last one, some more painted flowers. And the background of this one is actually kind of pretty too. It looks like the start of a canvas. What's your favorite DSP so far? I've showed you 3 collections. 4 collections. I showed 4 collections. Is there anybody that can tell me all 4 collections? Because if you tell me all 4 collections, I got another blend marker. All 4 of the paper collections, what are they called? Maybe I'll make this one worth 2 markers. How would that be? You can have a set that way. Okay, so let me know what they are. Okay, so then there's some fun products. So the product that I showed you that had this background right here, I can't say the name of it because then it would be cheating. I'd be giving somebody a hint. Has some matching ribbon, a ribbon pack that goes with it. And one of the ribbons is kind of like a linen-y, I guess it would, you could say. I don't know if you can see that. And then the other is linen thread, but it's linen thread in mossy meadow. So that's actually really pretty. So this is a dual ribbon pack. I think each one contains 5 yards of material. So it's a 10-yard pack. So you make sure you be keeping your eyes out because I'm working on my paper shares and my ribbon shares. So I'll be putting those out shortly so that you guys can all get a little bit of everything. Look at these. Now, those of you, for me as a team leader, like these are perfect for putting little gifts in for my team because they have the Stampin' Up! Logo on them. So they're little mini shipping boxes that you can put together. It'd be great to give as a gift for your UPS man. So, because he's always bringing the pretty boxes. So fold over the boxes. This one folds in. And then, you know, what better way to get some popularity, but this is washi tape. Can you all see what's on that washi tape? The washi tape says Stampin' Up. And it would be great to tape your little boxes closed. So yes, Ray, you do need to get in on some shares. It's the best way to get all of the brand new designer papers without having to incur all the costs. You get a sampling of each one. So make sure you keep your eyes out for that. All right, where are we? I have some ribbon that matches one of the product suites. Can you guys guess that this is going to be my favorite one? I have one that got broke in the box, so I'm trying to find that one. Okay, what else is in here? One of the collections. Oh, come on. Delivery man. Yes, there is a new stamp set with the delivery man. To me, it just reminded me of the UPS man. So these are some embellishments that go with the nautical suite. I'm not going to tell you the name because that would be cheating. You're close, Rachel, but you're not there. Okay. So these are anchors. I can't hold them in my hands because my fingernails are too long and you won't be able to see them, but they're little metal anchors and little captain's wheels. So these are little metal embellishments. These would actually make really cute earrings too, I think, guys. So, you know, if you're not a card maker, but you're still a crafter, you could make some really cute earrings out of these. Okay, so those are trinkets, they call them. All right, we're getting near the bottom of the box. Also coordinating with the nautical suite. This is really, really nice. This is some baker's twine, but it's a heavy baker's twine, and it's Night of Navy and Sahara Sand. So it's not that starch white that we've had traditionally. So it's a little bit more subtle, and I don't know, it's very warm and cozy to me. So it's got the Night of Navy and the Sahara Sand, and it comes on a 25-yard roll. 25 yards. Holy cow. We can tie up anything. Maybe even the dog. We can put the dog out. I don't know if she'd like that very much, but we might do it. We might try it. All right, what else is in here? I thought I had a spool of ribbon that was in rough shape, and I took it out. I wanted to take it apart. Oh, here it is. Okay, so this one came a little busted up, but that's okay. Can you see the color? It's petal pink. This is called Petal Pink Organdy Striped Ribbon. So I'm going to go ahead and open it just because that's how I roll. And I may have to try to glue this back on just so I don't make a mess of my ribbon. But I want you to see. Oh, here's the beginning. Ooh, I'm making a real mess. I'm going to have to re-spool this anyway. Okay, here we go. Look at that. It's organdy, so it's got that little bit of shine and shimmer to it. And it's the color is, let me put it against the black shirt. Can you see that it's the petal pink, or is my light too bright? It's petal pink, one of my favorite colors. Anything pink is my favorite. So those of you that know me know that. All right, let's see if there's anything else in here we have not seen. You've seen this, you saw that, you saw that. One last piece, and we're at the bottom of the box. All right, so one last piece. These are cork embellishments that go with one of the product suites that I can't tell you because nobody's guessed yet. So we have some cork leaves, some cork tags. Cork tags. Thank you, Virginia, for letting me know that you could tell it was petal pink or that you could see that it was pink. So these are cork tags. Okay. So in here, does it tell me how many pieces? 20 pieces. So 10 tags, 10 leaves. No. There's got to be more pieces. Yes. Look at these pretty little flowers. Also cork. They're really light, so they're going to be easy to adhere to your projects. I think those are the three designs. Okay. So, all right. One last try. Who is going to guess the four product suites that I showed the designer paper for? Because I want you to win something. All right, let me show you my samples created with the product suites that I showed you. So I showed you this sample already. This was from one of the suites and that delicious paper. I also made one vertically. So I made one horizontally and one vertically, so that you could see them. These are those cute little fuzzy embellishments. They actually have adhesive on the back. They stick very nicely. And they are sold in a little container, and I think you get 20 of them. Let's see what it says. You get 18 of them. So you get 18 of the little fuzzies. They'll go really, really nicely with my daisy card that I made. So I'm gonna be putting those on there. So those of you that came in late, this was the, all right, Bolte, you win again. Magnolia Lane, Perennial Essence. That's this one. Come Sail Away and Mosaic Moods. So this is the card that I created. I'm going to put these little yellow fuzzies inside my daisies, because I think that will just spruce it right on up. Okay. So here is another sample. This one says, follow your art. So I did not get this designer paper yet, but there is a whole pack of designer paper with artists in mind, and it's not just stampers. It has, there's one that has glue guns on it. There's one that has scissors all over it. So there's all different kinds of art things for you to see. Then my Come Sail Away sample. So this is made on one of our white note cards with some of the background paper, soft suede colors, Night of Navy colors, and I put one of the embellishments on it and some of the baker's twine. So this is created with the Come Sail Away bundle. Yes, Virginia, great, I love it. Which one were you commenting? Were you commenting on the Sail Away or the art one? All right. This is from the Bird Ballad. I have to tell you, one of the gals that was traveling with me, she was like, before we got there, she's one of my downline, before we got there, she's like, oh, I hope that we don't just see, you know, birds and hummingbirds and, I'm trying to think what else she said, flowers, hummingbirds, and butterflies. Could we let the butterflies go already? So when they started announcing this product suite, her eyes rolled. And then, but by the time we were done, she was like, well, it is really pretty. So this is actually not watercolored. I did not get this designer paper as of yet, but it's from the Bird Ballad suite. And the paper looks like it's watercolored. These I did with blends. So these are the little birds on the magnolia tree. Actually, I'm not even sure it's magnolia. I'm going to say that it's a flowering dogwood tree. So I made one of these horizontally and vertically, so that you could see the both of them. And I use the daffodil blends and the Flirty Flamingo blends and I think crumb cake for my coloring. So, well, I'm glad that you like the art and the birds. All right, and then one last sneak peek. If you are not a Paper Pumpkin subscriber, you are missing out on a lot. Paper Pumpkin has come a long way in the six years now that it's been going. And our kits keep getting better and better, and the projects are better. We get more supplies. It's all inclusive. And every single one of you deserves a 30-minute creative escape. So I don't know what you're waiting for. You need to get in on Paper Pumpkin. So this month, that we're in right now, April, I'm waiting for my kit. I hope it arrives in the next day or so. And it's going to be a distinctive stamp set, which are my favorite because, as I told you earlier, those are the ones that look real when you stamp them. They look like real flowers. So for the month of May, and the reason I'm bringing this up is that you all have time to subscribe. Get on there now. Get onto my website. Get into the Paper Pumpkin and sign up right now. It is a kit designed exclusively and especially with Shelly. It's called Hugs from Shelly, and it's, you know, about a year ago, Sarah designed one. I think Shelly was feeling left out. She got to design one. So this next project is actually a sneak peek of one of the projects that's in the kit. First thing I want to show you is I want to show you the envelope. The envelope is pretty, pretty, pretty. That's the inside. Outside, do you want to see the front? Who doesn't want to get an envelope that looks like that? Look at that pretty spring little birdie nest with the eggs in there. And here comes the sample. Okay, the card is crumb cake, that's the back, pre-printed on the front, but then you just stamp and embellish, and I think it's gorgeous. So everything that you need, Lori, you tuned in late, but you're going to want to rewind and go back and look at everything, because I just finished unpacking the box of all my pre-order stuff. So the other thing you're going to want to do is you're all going to want to get your hands on the 2019-2020 catalog. So if you are not on my mailing list or you've not been to class in a while, you need to make sure that you message me so that I can order enough catalogs. I always have extra. And I want to get this catalog into your hand as soon as I am able to. It is live for demonstrators, but unfortunately customers can't open it up as of yet. Don't worry, I've already nicely worn the pages for you. It's been with me and I've been using it and reading it and studying it. So lots and lots of good stuff. So keep your eyes peeled on stamppatties.com. I have a couple videos coming out soon. And paper shares, ribbon shares, embellishment shares are coming soon. My spring classes, and I am planning my first ever Stamp Patties retreat. It's going to be a weekend event. It's going to be held in a resort that's very similar to the cottages on Dirty Dancing. So if any of you have ever seen that movie, it's set back in the country, and we will have use of cottages that will sleep 3, 4, 5, and 6 people. I have use of the entire hall for the weekend. So that's going to be in August. I think the dates are August 16th to the 18th. So make sure if you're not on my newsletter, you get that as well. Whew, lots and lots. But more than anything, I want to say thank you to everybody for tuning in and watching this video. And for those of you that weren't able to, because we all have these terrible things called a job, I will be posting the replay so that you can look at it all and provide me your comments and feedback. So I want to say thanks to everybody for tuning in. Have a great rest of your day. Happy and a blessed Easter to you and your family. Thanks so much. Bye, everybody.